this was Olivet this morning when we were involved with Dr. Hagee that mentioned, Mr. Hagee that mentioned that people are aging in Newfoundland Labrador, like leaned over and like Ted Al and said, he's probably talking to the three of us. But it's my pleasure to be here. Good to see Brian Ward and Brian King from Spring Hill, I guess, this morning. And certainly to Jerry, we had a great announcement in Bombay just a few minutes ago. And Bob Wooden, great to be back in Grand Falls Windsor today. Congratulations to all the councillors and the mayors and people who have put their names in the ballots. First time we've been in your community since the municipal election. And we saw many of them were at the NML conference a few weeks ago. But, you know, thank you for putting your name on the ballot. And for all the volunteers that we have here, and especially, and I mentioned this in Bob this morning, especially when it comes to long-term care. You see a significant base of volunteers, no matter where you go in the province, that actually support residents in long-term care. And I want to say thank you for all of those. And to the tremendous staff, it takes some very special people, I will say, to actually work in long-term care sites. And we are so fortunate to have great staff members all across our province. I know, as Al said, it's something that you've been working towards for quite some time now, and that when you look at where we are as a province, there's no question, we know the stats, and that we are aging at a faster pace than other provinces within the country, but I don't see that as a negative. I would tell you that when we look around at some of the demographics that we have in Newfoundland Labrador, some of the best volunteers and community leaders that we have are still some of our older adults. They're still very actively involved. But we must prepare ourselves for some of the challenges that comes with aging populations. But it's not always in a negative way. The story of an aging demographic is something that is well known, and something that is well documented. And that within 10 years, we will go from the number of people that are 65 years of age and older from currently 19% of our population to 27%. So we are indeed growing at a faster pace, as I said. So in order to meet the present demands and the future demands in long-term care as a province, as a caucus, and as a cabinet, we need, working with our regional health authorities, we really need to put a spotlight, a focus on this important issue, and then make sure that we have the appropriate capacity in place. And the capacity comes in many forms. It's just not long-term care beds. Capacity could be community services. It could be the way families support their aging parents typically. So it is capacity in beds, but it's also community capacity as well. And we have also made a commitment to think innovatively and to use evidence to inform the decisions that we make and find the balance from where we are as a province, with the fiscal situation that we have, but balance that the needs of families in our communities. And so to do that, we must be open. We must be open-minded in the way we do things. And we can achieve those goals when we listen to people, when we work with people, compare where we are today to other jurisdictions that they deliver health care, and in some ways, not be shy in being innovative ourselves in Newfoundlanders and Labradors. There's no creative bunch in the world than a Newfoundlander and Labradorian. They find ways to respond to challenges, and that is exactly what we are all about. And over the last number of weeks and months, we have taken important steps in actioning our vision for healthcare. Earlier this month, we awarded a contract to build a new long-term care facility in Cornwall. And last week, we saw that construction begin by some of the planning for the major work that will be done will begin in April of 2018. That new facility will go a long way meeting demand on the West Coast. But we fully appreciate that it's long-term care beds that are needed right across our province. There's long-term care beds that are needed right here in Grand Falls, Windsor. And how that additional capacity will make better use of acute care beds, because they are connected, and to ensure that people receive the appropriate level of care in the appropriate place. So today, I am pleased to announce that a new 60-bed long-term care facility will be built in Grand Falls, Windsor.